Hello, today we're looking at unit. Unit, if you don't have a clue what it is, it's basically Unity 8. As you know, Ubuntu said Unity is dead, we're moving on to GNOME. The developers of Unity 8, or at least some of them, said we will port it on, we will continue the revolution, and they formed Unit. And in this video, we're gonna look at the beginning stages of Unit. We're gonna install it on Ubuntu 16.4. You can also install it on Debian. And we are just going to look at it. Of course, I've already noticed that most of it doesn't work yet. Like, I couldn't open up any of the apps. But it will give you a good idea. And they will improve it and they will grow. And it's just an matter of time that Unity 8 will be usable. And it's very excited. So we're gonna look at the beginning stages first, how to install it, and then a very quick look through the operating system. We have to run all these commands in a terminal, and you can also do some security checks, known issues. And what will happen next? So it's very beginning stages. So please don't be shocked. Be ready. I'm running this in VirtualBox so that I'm able to record it for you. So the mouse doesn't work well in the beginning. So there's many things if it's not perfect yet, but this is a start. And that's always exciting. So let's close the browser and you will see I've already put all the commands and also the things you can check at the security check. We won't do it in this video, but you can check it out. So we will just install it here. We will run all these commands. Let's open up a terminal. I'll press Ctrl, Alt, and T together. Move it to the left. I'm gonna move the commands to the... No, I'll move it to the right. I'm gonna move the commands to the left. I'm just gonna copy these commands into my terminal, one by one. Press type password, press enter. Second command. You can find them all in the description of this video. Press enter. And then the next command. At the moment it's very quick, but it's the upgrade part and the installation part takes quite some time. As you can see, it's very simple so far. Let's update our computer now. And then let's upgrade. As you can see, we got Unit in our updates now. So far so good. We are just waiting now. It is teaching us patience. And space that we upgrade those 122 packages. So it will take about 100 megabytes of download. Now, the installation will also take some. So let's say yes. And I'm gonna fast forward this part to make this video slightly shorter. See you soon. Fantastic. As we are finishing up with this part, we can start to copy the last command. It will also take some time to install the Unit desktop. Quite a funny name, but makes sense. As you can see, we are nearly finished. It's always a good sign. Let's paste the last command. Press enter. As you can see, this will take another 50 megabytes of download. info. So I'm gonna fast forward this again. See you soon. Fantastic, as we are finishing up with the last part of the installation, we can close our text document. You will also find all these commands and the link to the website in the description of this video. So don't worry about that. We can close our terminal as we are finished, and we can just log out of our computer. Which is fantastic. And we click here. We choose Unity. As you can see, it looks exactly like Unity's picture of the past. And let's type in a password. As I said, I'm running this in VirtualBox. And I tried it out before. And the mouse at the beginning gives some itches. There's a lot of apps, but I don't want to open up. But I'm sure it will be fixed soon. As you can see, the mouse is a bit weird at the beginning. It doesn't want to go to the other side, but there it went. If we click on one thing, anything, it starts to work fine. As you can see about this device, it tries to open up the apps. But then it gets stuck. Just gets stuck here. And if we go to our launcher, I don't know why this is a very good VM. I got like 4 gigabytes of RAM, free cores. You can click here and we'll try to open up the software center. Once again, it doesn't want to work correctly, but I'm sure they will fix it. It's not big things. As you can see, the best looks beautiful. You can search here. Let's type in terminal. As you see, it works just perfectly. And if you can use the down arrow to just move down. As you can see, all the apps is here. But it doesn't work yet. None of these things really works. As you can see, the mouse is all conked up. If we click here, it tries to open up. It does its best, but it just can't at the moment. And the browser is the same. The software center is the same. They're all basically the same. It doesn't mean... I don't think it's a bad thing. I think it's something very easy to fix. I think the mouse is something very easy to fix. I'm sure on hard metal it will be a much better experience. I don't think apps will open up yet. But I'm sure they will fix everything along the way. And if you press Alt and Tab, everything opens up so neatly and we can have a nice... It just looks stunning. They've really made it look awesome. And I just really hope it works for them. And if you go to a top launcher, as you all this mobile-y looking stuff. So it's all here, it all looks beautiful. You just need some love. And I'll be by your side for any new updates and upgrades. This is today the 25th of July 2017, and I can't wait to see what the guys will do in the future. You can install this on Ubuntu 16.4, most of the flavors, and also on Debian. Thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye.